Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. Now today we're going to be talking about the Daytona races, so the three premier races at Daytona for NASCAR. Just to let you know, I'm a little bit sick, so even though I may sound the same, I'm a little bit sick, so I won't really be shouting all the time anyways. So this is the Camping World Truck Series, as fucking ads are popping up, but I don't really care about that now. Just going to just try and cover that up. Anyways, so you already saw in the top three, you see it right there, is Ben Rhodes, Jordan Anderson, and Corey Roper. So Ben Rhodes gets the first win in the season, which basically makes him he is in the playoffs, the first driver to be in the playoffs. There's Jordan Anderson, Corey Roper, sorry, then Ryan Truex, Carson Hocevar, Sheldon Creed, John Hunter Nemechek, Cody, I'm going to butcher this name again, Ralbar, Chandler Smith, and Drew Dahl rounds out the top 10. Then Grant Enfinger, Chris Wright, Spencer Boyd, David Gilliland, Matt Crafton, Zane Smith, Danny Bowen, Jennifer Jo Cobb, Brian Dalzat, and Jason White rounds out the top 20. Then Austin Wayne Self, Austin Hill, Rafael Lassard, Haley Deegan, Brayton Mofford rounds out the drivers who were running in the top 25. The rest were in an accident or in the DVP. And those drivers were Timothy Peters, Johnny Sauter, Tyler Ankrum, Chase Purdy, Tate Fulgerman, Todd Gilliland, Stuart Friesen, David Krause, Gus Dean, Tanner Gray, and James Buescher. So those are the results for the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series Daytona. I think it was an Nextra Energy 250, if I remember correctly, which was 100 laps, even though it was actually 101 laps because it was overtime. But we'll ignore that. We now move on to the NASCAR Xfinity Series. This is, it's a weird name. Beef is What's for Dinner 300 at Daytona, which is the season opener at the Xfinity Series. And these are the results. So, Austin Cindric, last year's champion, punches his ticket very early to get into the playoffs, with Brent Moffitt second, Harrison Burton third, then Jeb Burton, AJ Allmendinger, Brandon Brown, Maya Snyder, Brandon Ganovic, Daniel Hemric, and Jason White rounds out the top 10. Now, I think the Jason White from Camping World Truck Series and in the Xfinity Series, those two are actually different drivers. This Jason White was formerly a NASCAR driver, even though he took a pretty long extended break. Jason White in the Camping World Truck Series, he's actually Canadian, unlike this one who's American and competed last year in the Gander Outdoor Truck Series back then. Next up, we have Joe Graff Jr., he's at Baccarella, Stephen Parsons, Ty Dillon, Kyle Weatherman, Matt Mills, Jesse Little, Ryan Vargas, Danny Bowen, and Timmy Hill rounds out the top 20. Josh Williams and Jeremy Clements rounds out the field for the drivers running, or even though there's probably more, but I can't be bothered to have a look. These are all the drivers who were in an accident or DVP or basically reason why they retired. We have Landon Castle, Tommy Joe Martins, Robbie Lyons, Riley Herbst, Josh Berry, Justin Allgaier, Justin Haley, and Chad Pincher rounds out the top 30. Then Ryan Sieg, Noah Gragson, Bailey Curry, Greg Golding, Colby Howard, Michael Winnett, Jeffrey Earnhardt, Brandon Jones, Cody Ware, and Alex LeBay rounds out the field. Now this is the most prestigious NASCAR race in its history. It is obviously the Daytona 500. It was won by fucking Michael McDowell. I don't know how, even though I did watch the race, well, a little bit of it, mainly the highlights, but I fucking don't know how he fucking won the race, but a front row motorsports car has won the Daytona 500. So, as you can see in the top three right here, we have Michael McDowell first, I don't know how, last year's champion Chase Elliott, and 2019's Daytona 500 champion Austin Dillon. They've got Kevin Harvick, Denny Hamlin, Ryan Preece, Ross Chastain, Jamie McMurray, Corey LaJoie, and Kyle Larson at the top 10. Then Cole Custer rounding out the field, and there are more drivers who are running, but they were just a lap down. They got Joe Logano, Brad Keselowski, Kyle Busch, Austin Cindric, who were in the accident of a massive, massive wreck in the final lap. Christopher Bell was running. There's Bubba Wallace, who was in the accident. The Ricky Stenhouse Jr., Chase Briscoe, and Joey Gaze rounds out the top 20. Then Cody Ware, Kurt Busch, BJ McLeod, Josh Blicky, Martin Truex Jr., William Byron, Tyler Reddick, Kaz Grala, Quinn Half, and Ryan Blaney rounds out the top 30. Then Chris Buescher, Anthony Alfredo, Matt Benedetto, Eric Almirola, Alex Bowman, Daniel Suarez, David Reagan, Ryan Newman, Eric Jones, and Derek Cope rounds out the field for the Daytona 500. So currently leading the standings in the Cup Series is Austin Dillon. I think it's just because I think he had a more stage. I don't understand how this works, but I guess it works. So this is how it is. Now for the standings, I'm only going to say the playoffs. So I'll read the playoffs this way, and then I'll do it like the playoff ranks. So this one is for the top 16, and then I think I'll talk about top 16, so 17th to 20th. I guess. So, Austin Dillon, Denny Hamlin, Kevin Harvick, Chase Elliott, Michael McDowell, Ryan Preece, Kyle Larson, Bubba Wallace, Joe Logano, Christopher Bell rounds out the top 10, Ross Chastain, Corey LaJoie, Kyle Busch, Jamie McMurray, Cole Custer, Brad Keselowski rounds out the playoffs, with Ricky Stenhouse Jr., Chase Briscoe, Joey Gase, and Kurt Busch looking in the outside end. So, if we go to the rankings, it's very, very similar, but it's actually exactly the same. It's just that Michael McDowell is now automatically in the playoffs because he did win the race. I don't know how. A little bit changes that here and there, but it's basically just the same. You can see it in this column here. It's basically the same. This one is for the top 12. So I'll talk about 13th through 16th. Look it in. So it is Austin Cindric, who's already locked himself in, then Ty Dillon, Brandon Brown, Harrison Burton, Jeb Burton, Maya Snyder, Daniel Hemric, AJ Allmendinger, Brandon Godovic, Jason White, Joe Graff Jr., Cesar Bacchella in the top 12. Then Stephen Parsons, Kyle Weatherman, Matt Mills, and Jesse Little ran out. I guess the driver's looking in. So those are the playoffs, basically exactly the same as it was previously in the actual standings. Now we go to the Camping World Truck Series. This one is for the top 10, so I'll talk about 11th through 14th. Ben Rhodes, Sheldon Creed, John Hahn Nemechek, Chandler Smith, Grant Anfinger, Corey Roper, Ryan Truex, Rafael Lassard, Carson Haseva, Cody Rauber rounds out the top 10, then Drew Dollar and David Gilliland rounds out the 12th. That's the top 10, so Cody Rauber is in the playoff bubble. Then Drew Dollar, David Gilliland, Chris Wright, and Spencer Boyd round out the top in the 14th, so 11th to 14th, those are it. But now I'm going to be talking about the entry list for the next race, which is the Daytona Road Courses. I think for all three series, if I remember correctly, yes it is. So this is the entry list. I think it's basically the same as it was previously, other than like some minor changes. Like James Davison is now in. He's from Australia. I'm only gonna observe these. I'm only gonna point out the changes from each one, which is very, very little. Same as there. Josh Blicky, Joey Gase, Cody Ware. Same thing with all that. Justin Haley is now in for the number 37. Ty Dillon is gonna be back in. Let's just see if he's actually going to make it into the field. Actually, I think he might automatically, but I don't know. Xfinity Series is kind of the same, other than some changes. So we got some changes here. Most notably, there's Andy Lally, who will be running some races in mainly the road courses. Miguel Paludo's back in NASCAR. He was previously in the Camping World Truck Series and also the Xfinity Series. We don't know who's going to be driving the 13. I was about to say Rick Ware Racing. No, it's actually SS Green Racing. I don't really know. I think 23 hasn't been announced. Chris Wright is going to be driving there. Jordan Anderson. He's going to be driving I think it's actually his first race, I think, in the Xfinity, but I don't know. I know this is Chris Wright's first. Jade Buford, that's also his first as well. I think include Greg Golden, but I don't know. Steven Lydas is first. Include Rodney Bassett Jr. And we don't know who's going to be in the number 99. Preston Pardes is also new as well. So for the Camping World Truck Series, there's very little changes other than as Bobby Rios, who will be driving for Jordan Anderson's number 3 truck. We don't know who's going to be driving the 02. We also don't know who's going to be driving the number 8. Some other changes I'm trying to look for as quickly as I can. We don't know who's going to be driving the number 34. That is for Josh for the Ream Brothers Racing. Jet Noland is going to be driving for the number 44 for Nice Motorsports. Roger Rios going to be driving for CMI Motorsports. We don't know who's going to be driving for Kyle Busch Motorsports. Sam Mayer's going to be driving for Henderson Motorsports, Henderson Racing. And Christian Eckes will be making his debut in Thor Sport Equipment in the number 98. So that is it for the entry list and also for the results. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. It might be a little bit boring, but hopefully I will get better. My voice is a little bit fucked, but I think at some point I will be better. But that is it for NASCAR. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Catch you guys on next time in the next one. Goodbye. Fast car, I want all the smoke. Yeah, all the smoke. Porsche 911 can't see me no more. I be up high, but I want some more.